Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another video in my Bird ID Through the Year series, and this one is going to introduce the diving ducks in the Aythia genus. And these are the five common species from that genus that are found in North America. These are the male plumages, and as you can see, we can roughly divide them into the red-headed males and the dark-headed males. On the other hand, the female plumages for all five are a little more subdued, with overall brown and gray tones. So let's start with the red-headed males, which would be redhead and canvasback. And the first thing you might notice is that on redhead, the body is sort of a light gray color, whereas on canvasback, it is white. But in some lighting conditions, the gray body on redhead can look pretty washed out, so this field mark is not necessarily as clear-cut as it would seem at first appearance. So it's more reliable to use details of the bill and the head structure. Redheads have a pretty rounded head, and they also have sort of a blue-gray bill with a dark tip. And contrast that with the all-dark bill on canvasback that sort of smoothly transitions into this sloping forehead. So it really gives the impression that the head and bill function as a unit on canvasback, whereas on redhead it looks like you have the bill attached to the head. So that gives us a nice transition to talk about female canvasbacks, because they have that same distinctive head shape as the males. So you can see the all-dark bill that's sort of tapered and smoothly transitions into this sloping forehead. And as we'll see once we get to the other females, canvasbacks have a lighter body than the scaup, redheads, and ringneck ducks. So now that we have canvasback out of the way, let's continue on with the rest of the male plumages. And with the dark-headed males, you're really dealing with two plumages because greater and lesser scaup are pretty similar to each other. So let's look at ringnecked duck first. And the important thing on these are that they have a black back. And then the side is mostly gray, but they have this white spur towards the front. Then they have a gray bill with an extensive black tip that has a white ring separating the gray from the black. And then we have scaup, which tend to have a more uniform white or grayish color in the sides without that contrast towards the front. They also have a lighter gray back compared to the black back on ringneck duck. And the bills are mostly this blue-gray color with just a very small amount of black at the very tip. And since greater and lesser scaup are so similar, let's take a look at some ways that you can identify them. And head shape tends to be one of the more reliable ways of doing that. Greater scaup tends to have a pretty similar head shape to redhead. So you have that rounded head with a peak towards the front, and you can see the same thing here on the greater scaup, where it definitely has more of the peak in front of the eye. And then lesser scaup tends to have a head shape that's a little more similar to the shape of ringneck duck, where it's a little taller looking, a little more square looking, and it also has a little bit of a peak to the rear of the head. So you can see the same thing here on lesser scaup. Instead of having the peak in front of the eye, it's definitely more towards the rear. Greater scaup tends to have a slightly larger bill than lesser as well, and they tend to have more black at the very tip of the bill than lesser, but those differences are very subtle and can be pretty tricky to see in the field. So I thought it would be helpful to pick through this raft of scaup to see if we can identify which is which based on the head shapes. And the head shape works on the females as well, so we can evaluate all of the birds in the photo. And just quickly scanning through, I'm definitely seeing a lot of these birds look like the head is peaked towards the front of the head. So that would suggest that we're looking at mostly greater scaup here. You can see that's very much true throughout the entire flock. Almost all of these birds are obviously peaked towards the front of the head. So then the question is, can we pick out any lesser scaup in this group? And you may want to pause the video so that you can do a proper survey of all of them. And of course, depending on the angle, it could be a little bit tricky to identify some of these individuals to species, but that's perfectly fine. If you can't tell for sure, just mark it down as greater slash lesser scop. Most of the good birders I know make frequent use of slashes for these when conditions aren't allowing you to identify every single bird. It can definitely be tough when they're bouncing around and the flock is sort of moving. So definitely no shame in leaving them unidentified. So let's go through these and I'll mark the ones that I think are good candidates for lesser scop. So starting from the top left here, this does look like a lesser scop. And going along the top, this one also looks good. This one is mostly obscured, but that looks good as well. So does this one. And coming down the side, the rest of these look like graders. Then we have this bird that looks like a lesser. And coming down sort of the middle here, these all look like graders. All graders again on the left side, but we do have this one that's just barely hiding in here that we can see this head shape. And I think this is all of the lessers that are safely identifiable here. And I like this photo because we have side-by-side examples of female, lesser, and greater, and then we also have male examples of lesser and greater that really allow you to compare the head shapes between these two species. So let's now move on to the female plumages. And with the females, there are three main things you want to be looking for. You want to look for strong white at the front of the face, you want to look at the color of the bill, and also the head shape. So let's start with the face, and the female scop usually have pretty strong white here near the base of the bill, and ringneck duck and redhead, a lot of times it'll look a little pale there, but usually not strong white. Scop also tend to have slightly darker looking heads, which when you combine that with the white at the base of the bill, it gives it a higher contrast look. And we talked a little bit about bill color with males, but the females also have the same colors. So the scop have sort of a blue-gray bill with just a very little bit of black near the very tip. And then ringneck duck and redheads have a significant amount of black near the tip, and ringneck duck usually has a strong ring of white that separates the gray from the black, and sometimes you also see that same thing in female redheads. And the head shape works the same way for the females as it did with the males. So greater scop and redhead both have pretty round heads that are a little bit front heavy, sort of peaked in front of the eye. And then lesser scop and ringneck duck have sort of taller and more balanced heads that are more peaked towards the rear. So let's try to put everything together for the females. The first question you want to be asking is whether it's a canvas back. So remember the all dark bill and the smooth transition into the sloping forehead. And if it's not a canvas back, then you want to move on to using the facial plumage and the bill color to determine if it's a scop or a ringneck duck or redhead. So the scop would have the white towards the base of the bill and then a blue-gray bill with just a little bit of black near the tip. And ringneck duck and redhead would have more of the just pale base of the bill, not white, and a more extensive black towards the tip of the bill. And then you want to use the head shape to figure out what you have. So if you have a scop with a very rounded head that's peaked towards the front, you have greater scop. And if you have a non-scop with that same head shape, that would be redhead. And likewise, if you have a scop with that taller, more balanced head that's a little more peaked towards the rear, that would be lesser scop. And if it's a non-scop with that same head shape, that would be a ringneck duck. So there you have what is probably a slightly unconventional way of putting all of those together. And I'm curious, did that click with you, or are you still a little bit confused on how to identify these? So let me know in the comments if I need to make follow-up videos to cover these in more detail. And as always, like, subscribe, and consider signing up for my daily bird ID email. And I hope you will join me in my next video. Thanks for watching.